Bright spots are a celebration of the exemplary work going on in Cincinnati Public Schools. This bright spot is about speak up, speak out.
You know, quite honestly, after the killing of George Floyd, Superintendent Laura Mitchell reached out to me and we had a good conversation around change and needed change.
Speak Up, Speak Out is a monthly online discussion offering students opportunities to share experiences of racial injustice with CPS and community leaders. Our goal is to empower young people to effectively create change.
Hello, everybody. I'm Chris Scott.
My name is Simone Simmons.
Jaden Harris.
Virtual Skills. I attend the Riverview Academy.
Keyshawn Townsend, class of 2021.
From there, the rest is history. You know, the kids took it from there.
It's a chance to hear the raw emotion from students unfiltered.
It's like two different kinds of history.
I shouldn't have to, like, change how I, like, act or, like, how I talk.
Like, they'll make eye contact to you and then go to, like, a white kid or something like that.
Poverty that I am, it's an evolution of racism.
Well, it means a lot because it's letting my voice be heard and it's given the opportunity for other Black students as myself in the community to let them express their feelings on how they're feeling about the death of George Floyd and other Black killings in the world.
They're facing the same problems. They felt like they have witnessed racism. They have seen privilege take place in their schools. And to hear them talk and to hear a kid from Wanna Hills and a kid from Western Hills go through the exact same thing, it shows that it is a problem and it's something that needs to be addressed.
What are some other ways to be civically engaged without voting in an election?
Have you ever felt like cornered or not being able to say something about it?
What steps are you going to take next to make sure our demands are met?
So the kids addressed the areas that they wanted to see change, and then they addressed the people that can make that change, and then we went straight to those people.
Based on hearing what the students had to say and speak up, speak out in the curriculum department, you know, we were listening with open ears because that really, we said, this is going to impact our work moving forward in this really double pandemic year when we've got racial injustice going on and the COVID situation where we don't get to see our students face to face all the time. We knew that we had to come back to school in a way that students felt, number one, that they're safe. Number two, that their experiences are being, that they have a place to speak to their experiences and how that's impacted their education.
We, as the adults, need to have a sense of urgency about what you want to see in your schools.
They are moving that, they're transitioning from talk to action.
And many of the concerns that you have, I share those same concerns.
Students have 100% stake in this work, and to move forward in any way without taking their words and their thoughts and their voices into consideration would not be doing the work in the way we need to be doing it.
They're actually like listening to what we're saying, so I really appreciate that, and I feel like we're making the right steps to make a change in the Black community.
They have the ability to make change in a way that we did not and that we cannot. That's our role as administrators in a school district, you know, support those kids as they make that next step and to empower them and inspire them to make that true change.